Good day, everyone. Welcome to Learn with MN. In this video, we will discuss the next geometric shape tool of Inkscape, that is the Ellipse Tool. The tool with the circle symbol in the toolbar is Ellipse Tool. You can also select it via the shortcut key E. As from the name, the Ellipse Tool is used to draw ellipses, circles, and arcs. Just left-click and drag to draw an ellipse as you like. To move, scale, or rotate the ellipse, we will use the selection tool. You can switch to the selection tool by pressing the spacebar. Now you can move and scale it. You can also come back to the ellipse tool by pressing it again, or double-click on the ellipse can also open the ellipse tool. If you want to learn more about the selection tool, you can find its tutorial video on the I button. When the ellipse is drawn, three handles appear on the ellipse. Two are squares, and one is a circle. Square handles at the top and left sides are used to change the size of the ellipse. The top one is used to resize vertically, and the left one is used to resize horizontally like this. Now, this circle handle on the right side is used to convert the ellipse into an arc or segment, let's say like a pie slice. This depends on the position of the handle. There are two handles for the arc start and end, but initially, both handles are on top of each other, that's why you only see one. When I drag the handle, you see the other handle is visible now. You can also notice the shape is changed to a pie slice, or in other words a Pac-Man shape. Now, you can drag and adjust both start and end handles to form the desired shape. Let's understand some technicalities of these handles to form different shapes. To draw an arc, keep the mouse pointer inside the circle while dragging the arc handles, like this. This creates an arc shape. For the pie segment, like Pac-Man, keep the mouse pointer outside the circle. This will create a pie slice. Now, let's discuss the different options of the ellipse tool in this control bar. These two fields are used to resize an ellipse by changing its radii with any desired value. The field labeled Rx is for the horizontal radius or the width, and Ry is for the vertical radius or the height of the ellipse. You can enter your desired value here as per need. Similarly, start and end are used for setting the start and end of the arc. Both indicate the angles in degrees between which the pie or arc extends. This drop-down menu shows the current unit of measurement for the ellipse. From this menu, you can change it to other available units like pixels, centimeters, inches, etc. Let's say, I want to resize this ellipse to 60 mm in width and 40 mm in height, and I want to make an arc of this ellipse with a start angle 30 and end angle 300 degrees. So, you can see a perfect ellipse, and an arc is created with my desired values and unit. You can create a circle by keeping the Rx and Ry both same. Another way to make a circle is by using the control key. Hold down the control key and drag the mouse. This will create a perfect circle. Control is used to preserve the width and height ratio of the object. To learn more about Ellipse Tool from practical work, refer to these two tutorials. You can find them in the I button and in description also. These illustrations are created with Ellipse Tool. Moving forward with these three options. These three buttons are activated when the arc handles are dragged. In other words, when the value of start and end is not zero. All buttons express their meaning by their icon. Let's see them practically also. This button switches the arc to a pie slice, or a closed shape with two radii like this. The second one switches a closed shape into an open arc like this. And the third button switches the open arc back into a closed shape. Last but not least, this button is used to restore the original ellipse shape. If I click it, you see it has made an ellipse again, and the value of start and end is changed to zero. That was all for the Ellipse Tool of the Inkscape. In upcoming videos, we will discuss the next shape tool of Inkscape in detail, so stay tuned. If you have any queries, feel free to write in the comment section or contact us on our website. Its link is in the description. If you like this video, please like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon so you don't miss any updates. Thank you for watching.